kind of humbling for me to be here. I appreciate the accolades and seeing the good work that not only myself but also the other teachers do over at Beloit Memorial. As she said, 27 years and then 2 years at Beloit Memorial, it was a great opportunity to come down here and take on the next challenge. And it was just pleasant, everything was pleasant, one after another, one surprise after another, not necessarily surprised at some. In terms of the faculty that I work with, the students, and just the whole culture of the school, it was really refreshing. So, in hindsight, great move for myself. I was told that I wanted to, you'd like to, me to say a few words about getting to know me as a person, as a teacher, etc. And I thought probably the best way to get to know me is that I invest in the students that come into not only my classes but also the students that I get to know. And all of them will tell you that I take a vested interest in them to be somebody. For them to come down and they already know, you know, the thing that when somebody needs to pass or whatever. They have seniors that do the running or take the pass out of this class, give it to the instructor and send somebody out. They're always seniors, so every time they come in, they say, oh, what are you doing next week? And they already know the question, and the kids ask them that before they come in. And they'll say, well, I'm not sure yet. And they'll go, oh, okay, well, hopefully you find your way. If you need some help, I'll be more than happy to help you out. So for my students, we work on making a decision. So I use the seniors, the upperclassmen, for example, and say, you know, by the time you get your senior year, halfway through you should have something figured out to at least have some direction, be that continuing education, get a job, or possibly the military, and I do whatever I can to help them make that decision. Then it goes into building the confidence in, you know, maybe you might not make the right decision, or you might figure out they want to do something different. You know, do it while you're young. Don't wait until you get old and then really isn't hard to change. You got to move from one place to the other or change direction or whatever. Do it while you're young. Take those chances. And I do that in my teaching too. So while we're working out in the shop, we do a lot of hands-on stuff. I just use welding for example. The kids will start off and they'll watch me do it and then they'll come back. And it's inevitably, as I refer to it many times, yeah, that's a train wreck, dude. Absolutely. And they get a little discouraged and they come back and spend a little bit of time with me and then build their confidence back up. They see that improvement and then they continue on. And a lot of them grab a hold of that and they'll continue to improve and then become a contest in the class to see, you know, who can get better, who can get better faster, who ends up being the best. And just to build that confidence and build that competitive nature in them that they are capable. They can go out and succeed in life. And yeah, they're going to have some mistakes. They're going to have some setbacks. It doesn't just come easily. As I, one of my phrases I use in there, I mean, you know, you guys look at this and you think you're going to do it like in, you know, one class period. I mean, I'm a trained professional and it's going to take a little bit of time. I didn't do this overnight either. I was where you sat. I did the same thing. I had to go through the same trials and tribulations. So my experience in not only going through my high school years and how to find my way and what I was going to do, I got lucky. I was asking for tools and power tools and stuff when I was like in fifth, sixth grade. So it was kind of I was lucky in that respect where I knew where my talents lie, what I liked, and I just pursued that path. Also with my military experience, I have 30 years now in the military. I serve in the Wisconsin Army National Guard. And I've gone through the whole gamut of a number of different jobs, occupations, and change and transition, and eventually became an officer and went into the engineers. Where I finally found home. So I use that to kind of guide them also in terms of you're not always going to make the right decision, but at least you're moving in a direction. So they use that also to at least keep their interest a little bit and know that, you know, things just don't fall into your lap. You have to get out there and kind of hustle for it. You got to look for what's going to be work for you and again, pick a direction. So with that being said, I use a lot of my influence, my connections in that to bring in business partners in that, pick any occupation to come in and do a presentation. They center around what I teach. I also bring in a recruiter or two in. They explain to me what's involved in the National Guard, what's involved in active duty, and I tell them, well, I'm not trying to move you in any direction whatsoever. I'm trying to educate you so you know what's involved with, what are the five different branches, what are the make an informed decision. With that being said, I think you have a pretty good idea of what goes on in my classroom, and it's a caring thing to where we try to take care of it. And with that, I just want to thank you for the honor of being chosen as Teacher of the Month. I appreciate it very much. Thank you.
Certificate of appreciation and recognition of our community's indebtedness to the teaching profession and the most valued contribution of its members to the development of our students, as exemplified by the unselfish personal devotion to the teaching of Christopher Klatt, Beloit Memorial High School. Congratulations.